I heard you say that, you know, your house was always full of kisses, was always full of the patter of little feet.
Uh-huh. Yeah. I have a very close-knit family on both sides, my in-laws and my direct family. And we always celebrated birthdays together, Christmas. I celebrated almost every holiday. And they really loved to be around their family, so there was always happiness in my home. And it was something that was key to me when starting a family. I wanted to be able to have in-laws where we got along, where we all, where it wasn't, you know, any separation. They were still my family. I wouldn't say those are my in-laws. I'd say this is my family. And I feel like I was just truly blessed to have that, to have, you know, two families. Some people don't have one, and I had two families.
If it's not too hard, and if you don't want to, I certainly understand. Can you just try to walk us through what happened? I mean, I know the boat started to take on water. I know that they had said that there was a storm coming. They had mm-hmm. mentioned life jackets, but they didn't tell people to put life jackets on in advance. When the water started coming in the boat, what happened?
When we first got out to the water, we were so excited because it was hot. It was really hot. And they told us a storm was coming. They told us to make sure we get out to the water first. And it was fine at first, and then it started getting rocky and started, you know, but it was, water was splashing inside the boat. But as we had been told, the boat can take on up to 18-foot waves. It was 18 to 20 feet, I believe. And so it wasn't really scary. We were also told that there are life jackets and they're above you, but you don't need to know where they are because you won't need to use them. So we didn't. We were told to stay seated in our seats, and we from what I can see, the boat, the people on the boat did what they were supposed to do.
Do you remember getting tossed into the water?
It was two to three of us to a seat, per the instructions. So I was in the very front seat, and my oldest son is on the autism spectrum. He was very excitable. So I wanted to make sure I could keep a hold of him when, you know, if he saw anything or if he got splashed with water. And my baby was asleep, and my husband was holding her. And then my middle son was right next to him. So as the first big wave came in, it looked like, from what I could tell, it looked like the water just came into the boat, but then it washed out the back. But when the last big wave came in, I lost hold of my baby. I didn't know the boat had capsized. I thought it just went under. And I jumped up and immediately started floating. And I hit my head on, I got pretty banged up. I was so disoriented and I couldn't see anything. So I just started pushing with my hands, trying to find a way out. And I felt somebody push my leg. And I couldn't find any of my family. And I swam. And it seemed like the more I swam, the farther in the water I got. And it was so cold. It was so cold. And I remember just praying, saying, Lord, let me get to my babies. Let me get to my babies. And I couldn't get to them. And then I just let go. I said, if I can't get to them, just let me go. Just let me go. If I can't get to my family, let me go. And I let go. And then I felt myself floating. And I felt the water warm up. So I knew I was getting closer to the surface. And then when I came to, There were people that had, they were throwing out life vests off of a big river boat. We were next to a big river boat. They were throwing off life vests, and then people started jumping in the water. And I just remember them dragging me out because I was trying to just stay. I was trying to stay afloat, but the water was so heavy and it kept pushing me back down. So, when they got me situated, I didn't see any of my people. And then my nephew came running out.
I heard someone ask you when you were at the hospital if you're glad that you survived, and you said you weren't sure at that time. I know you you have a strong faith. How are you holding on?
Well, somebody told me that when they found my husband, he had all three of my babies. So the reason I couldn't find him is because he was protecting them. So I didn't know that at first because a lot of details were kept because they didn't have all the details in yet. That right there will keep me fighting for my family forever. The memory of all of my family, not just my children and my husband, but for my mother-in-law, my father-in-law, my uncle, my nephew, my sister-in-law, and my surviving nephew. I'll always fight for them. To know that he did exactly what he always told me when we first met. I will always take care of you and our children. I'm sorry, Anderson.
No, nothing to be sorry about. I wish I could just hug you right now. I'm so sorry for your loss, and I know there's people all around the world who are thinking about you and praying for you and praying for your nephew.
Yes.
And I hope that gives you some strength in the difficult days and weeks and months ahead.
Yes, it definitely does, and it has.
Tia Coleman, thank you for talking to us. And again, my thoughts and my prayers are with you and your nephew and all those who survived. Thank you so much.
Thank you.